Okay, class, okay, settle down. Before we get started, David has something he'd like to read to us.
Hello, my name is David, and I am autistic. I look like most of the boys, and I have many of the same interests, but I am different in many ways. Autism causes me to behave differently than what you may think or expect. I have difficulties with some things that most people don't have trouble with. People with autism have challenges in social situations. I often have a hard time understanding people. Most people can understand expressions and body language, which tells you about what a person is thinking and feeling. I have difficulties with metaphors such as pull your socks up. I think you are telling me to pull my socks up, but now I understand that you may mean pay attention. This is because I think literally and expect the words to mean what they say. Most people have sensory problems. They may feel very sensitive to what they taste, smell, see, or hear. But autistic people have a difficult time handling them. These difficulties are not exactly the same for everyone. If I'm in a crowded place with loud noises, it can hurt my ears. So to reduce the noise, I cover my ears. I do not like to be hugged or kissed unless I'm the one who is doing it. Getting my teeth clean was not easy. It took my parents a long time to find a dentist who understood my sensitivity. She explains what is going to happen ahead of time, and she asks me to touch and feel the instruments before she puts them in my mouth. She works with me slowly and does not force me to do anything I don't want her to do. Kids with autism generally like to talk about topics that interest them only. For example, I like to talk about sports, trains, or Legos. I feel safe and confident when I talk about things I like a lot. Sometimes I forget that not everyone is interested and I talk about them too much. I might need help in changing the subject. I'm not able to read your face and see that you are bored. So just tell me and I will do my best to listen. I used to have a difficult time traveling, waiting in lines, going through airport security, or the plane being late caused anxiety for me. But now that I have traveled a lot, I am more flexible with not knowing everything before traveling. My parents would talk to me ahead of time, explaining as best they could every detail, and that has taught me to ask questions now before doing anything new. My brain is very good at storing facts and figures, but I have difficulties with reading comprehension and using words correctly. Some of us are fortunate to be more high-functioning than others. Having autism has advantages. I can easily tell you the capitals of every state, coaches of every NBA basketball team, name all 30 baseball teams, and what city they are in. I am very, very observant. I can watch a basketball player make a free throw and copy him, or watch a bowler make a strike and imitate his arm movement. That helps me be a better bowler and basketball player. Autism is a condition that affects the way the brain processes information. Not everyone has autism, and it is not an illness. It will not go away. No one knows exactly why people have autism. I will always have autism, but as I grow up with the help of friends and family, I can learn a lot of things that come naturally to most people. You can help me by understanding that I have autism and by not making fun of me. You can tell your friends and family what you have learned about autism. Being patient and understanding with all of us who have autism will support us greatly. Thank you.